sea. We went to Cuba to study ecology of tropical marine communities. We stayed in the town of Playa, Larga, Matanzas. It was home base for our daily snorkeling. On land we were laying in the sand until we learned the parrotfish's master plan of making it all from their poo-poo-ohhh.
Ew.
So into the water we all swam, where we had surveys that we ran, and in the surveys this is what we saw, yo. Pescadito. Scaridae son muy bonito. They got colors to outshine a rainbow. Their blood is royal, but they clean the sea flow. Pescadito. Labrador parrot, both big and small. 100 women at his beck and call. He's the biggest, baddest pimp of them all.
Super, super, super. Cuba, Cuba.
Parrotfish from tropical land, then go poop out sand. Grasses hang out in harems. Son mis favoritos.
Favorito, favorito, baby.
Passing you their turf, you're in the zona de peligro. Provoke mom, will fight to the death. Dad will turn into mama.
That's pro citizen and pro tandry.
Augustus bomba centrade. Splendid front bomba centrade. Then chaos bomba centrade. Great bellus bomba centrade. We ain't no damsels in distress, they say. Bomb bomb will take you on anytime, night or day.
Bomb bomb.
They're like that old man living at the end of your kayak. Get off, get off, get off, get off, get off my lawn. They say they'll nip and bite you, but it's really not that bad. Hey, they're the moms now that used to be daddy. Pescado bonito. Everywhere that we go, we're learning who you are. Poquito, poquito. We see you project schooling. There ain't no one you're fooling. We know you're on the move, not looking for refueling. Pescado bonito. Everywhere that we go, we're learning who you are. Poquito, poquito. We see you in cenotes. We see you from Los Portes. We see you on the reef shelf out at El Tanque.
Hey!
Pescadito. Tetradon deformis are awkward weirdos with large bodies and fins pequeño. They don't care, they just wanna eat solo. Pescadito. Polacentridae avoid the sunlight, hiding under ledges, staying out of your sight. These are truly creatures of the night.
Shit, shit, it, shit it. Sube, sube.
Parrotfish from tropical land, then go poop out sand. Restless hang out in harems. Stems on mis favoritos.
Favorito, favorito, baby.
Passing near the turf, you're in the zona de peligro. Provoke mama, fight to the death. And dad'll turn into mama.
That's pro citizen and pro tandry.
From Havana out to Los Coco, we have fun with fish wherever we go, just like Isla Mar in Puerto Rico.
Amor.
Resting out in harems. Stems on mis favoritos.
Favorito, favorito, baby.
Estos son nuestros amigos.
Biology.
Pescadito. Little fish.
Hi everyone, thanks for watching our awesome Pescadito music video. For those of you who found exactly how hilarious it was, congratulations on being total bio nerds.
And for those of you who aren't bio nerds, here's a little bit more explanation about the fish that we sang about in our video.
Parrotfish poop. Has anybody ever thought about that?
I hadn't until I'd been on these trips.
So if you had noticed in our video, we showed a lot of fish pooping in the video. That was actual sand coming from actual fish. That's right. The sand that you bury yourself up to your neck in is actually parrotfish poop.
This is a lot of poop.
Yeah, it is.
So parrotfish are super cool. They're really important to reef health because their main function is that they are grazers. So they spend about 90% of their time just eating algae off of the reef. And that's algae that would be competing with coral life. So they have teeth that fuse into a beak, and that beak helps them pull the algae off of the coral and the rubble and the calcium carbonate substrates. Their beak is so strong that they end up pulling off a whole bunch of that calcium carbonate and other inorganic matter and ingesting it. And well, they can't digest it, so what happens? They poop out sand. And they can actually poop out up to about 200 pounds of sand a year.
That is a lot of poop.
A lot of poop.
Can you imagine cleaning that?
Yeah, no thanks. So the next fish that we sang about in the video was the Labradae family, or the wrasse.
More specifically, we sing about the bluehead wrasse. You see them all over our video because we saw them all over Cuba. That is because they are the most common reef fish in the tropical Western Atlantic.
And that's saying something.
Yeah, tell me about it.
Hey, don't they have really interesting mating habits?
Yeah, they do. So they have all the yellowfish, all the small ones, those are the females, and they make up what's called a harem. And then you have the one larger fish that's got a blue head, and he's called the super male.
So he's like the pimp.
Yeah, exactly. What a lot of people don't know, though, is that not all the yellow ones are females. They have what's called sleeper males that hide out disguised as women to hang out around them, and then upon spawning season happens, they streak across to spread their seed and fertilize eggs undetected, in a process not all would guess is called streaking.
That's sneaky.
The next fish on our list of the top five fish we saw in Cuba is what most would consider an awkward swimmer.
And that's actually a real classification in at least one fish identification book. So the fish that we were looking at specifically are trunkfish, and they, just like we sing in our lyrics, have large bodies and fins pequeño.
That's little fins for those who don't speak Spanish.
But they eat pretty much everything. They are omnivores, so they eat a ton of plant matter, and they also eat things like sea slugs and snails.
That's gastropods for those who care.
So they're like the garbage trucks of the sea. They eat everything. So you know those dark, shady characters that hang out in alleyways that make you want to just walk just a little bit faster? These next fish remind me of those characters.
That's because these fish are only found in the deepest, darkest depths of the reef. The squirrel fish.
That's Holocentridae for those of you who have been paying attention.
Now these squirrel fish get really protective of their crevices because that's where they build their lives, their families. So when bigger fish swim on in and threaten the squirrel fish has to get kind of creative on how to protect itself. Usually that's in the form of visual aggression displays or using its voice.
Its voice? Could you elaborate on that?
Yeah. So the squirrel fish, they don't have a voice like you and me. So they use their swim bladder. Using a sonic muscle, they beat against their swim bladder to make these beating noises underwater that scares away predators.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah. And studies have also been done that show that it works the other way around. Researchers have used dolphin noises to scare squirrel fish back into their holes.
Oh, so now we have a way to send those shady characters back where they belong.
Yes. So from watching the video, it should be obvious by now that our favorite fish is the damselfish. And it should be everyone's favorite fish because it's basically the coolest fish in the whole reef.
That's right, they have basically no fear.
Literally, these little guys will swim up to a full-grown diver and attack their face just to defend their territory.
That territory they're defending so strongly has been in their family for generations and generations and generations.
So this land that has been in the family for generations is home to actually farmland for these fish. These actual fish farm algae to support their homes. So they have literal lawns, fish with lawns. Can you imagine that?
So when we're singing about the grumpy old dude at the end of your street that's saying, get off your lawn, that's actually accurate.
Well, I mean, not 100% accurate because it's actually females that defend the territory in the damsel world.
Good point.
The damselfish is actually female dominant, so when a female dies, the male would then take over the female role by changing into a female.
And that's protandry.
Exactly. Oh, that reminds me of a fun fact. Did you know that clownfish are a member of the damsel family?
I did not.
So think about what that means for Nemo's dad when Nemo's mom died.
What? Wait, what?
Yeah. We're talking about Marlena, here.
Oh, man.
Hi, everyone. I'm Kara.
And I'm Aaron.
And we just want to thank you guys for watching this video in its entirety, especially those of you who might be grading it.
Yep, we're talking about you, Dr. Schenker.
And we have a bunch of other people we'd like to thank for making this video such a success. So if you care to look, then we just want to watch the credits roll.
Resting out in harems, temples son mis favoritos.
Favorito, favorito, baby.
Estos son nuestros amigos.
Biology.
Pescadito.